Hi, it's Zach with Cable Wholesale. Today I want to show you how quick and easy it is to make your own Cat6a patch cables. Our Cat6a patch cables not only can save you time and aggravation, but we offer various lengths and colors of these Cat6a patch cables. You can take a look at these cables by searching our website. You may find it easier to purchase our lifetime warranted cables in many standard lengths. But if you're still determined to make your own, let's get to it. If you have some custom lengths you want to create, you can use our stranded Cat6a bolt cable. Cat6a patch cables can be made in lengths up to 30 meters, roughly 98 feet. Let's go over the list of parts you'll need to make your own Cat6a cable. You'll need a bulk stranded Cat6a cable, RJ45 connectors for Cat6a stranded cable, a cable stripper for network cable, a screwdriver to comb out the conductors, a pair of sharp cutters that we'll use to remove the center spline in the cable and trim the 8 conductors, and lastly an RJ45 crimp tool. Using your cable stripper, score the outer jacket. The outer jacket will come away. Using a cable stripper will ensure that you don't nick any of the wires inside and take the guesswork out of knowing how deep to cut the jacket to expose the inner wires. Use the cutters to remove the center spline in the cable. Pull down the 4 twisted pairs to get them out of the way. Use your cutters to cut the 4 wings of the spline. Give it a twist and it should pull right off. Let's take a look at the RJ45 ends now. This is a 3-piece set. It really helps to keep you from making mistakes. The first part is the wire separator. Next is the wire guide. Lastly is the RJ45 connector. The wire separator goes to the base of the exposed conductors. We'll separate the orange conductors from the brown. Here in the middle, we'll separate the green conductors from the blue. Now we'll untwist the 4 pairs and straighten the individual conductors. I like to use a screwdriver, but you can use your fingers. Now it's time to get the conductors in the correct alignment. Following the 568B standard, we have orange stripe, orange, green stripe, blue stripe, green, brown stripe, and brown. Following this color code, you can see why we separated the conductors in that specific order. Time to move on to the wire guide. If you run your finger along it, you'll find there's a flat side and another that has slits. You will also notice that the conductors are staggered. It can be a pain with some connectors to get the conductors to seat properly. This wire guide really helps. Working with the slit side facing you, insert the conductors into the wire guide. Once the conductors are in, just rock the wire guide back and forth. Don't force it. The conductors will go through the front of the guide. You should have all the solid color conductors closer to you and the striped conductors away from you. With the connector, the wire guide inserts all the way to the front of the RJ45 connector. Let's push the wire guides down to the wire separator. And trim the conductors flush with the wire guide. Now with the tab facing away from you, insert the cable into the RJ45 end. Those slits we felt on the wire guide are the spaces where the contacts pass through to make contact with the individual conductors when we crimp it down. The last thing we need to do is crimp down the connector. And voila! Repeat these on the other side, and you've made your own Cat6a. Time to take over the world. Making your own Cat6a cable doesn't have to be so difficult. Just follow the steps and tips I showed you today, and with a little bit of practice, you'll be a pro in no time. If you have any questions, our tech support is here to help, Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Pacific, by phone or live chat on our website. Thanks for joining me today. If you found this video helpful, hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you for watching.